Hello friends, welcome back to Sojanya's English class. And in today's class, we are going to learn about one of the functional elements of English grammar, that is reporting imperatives, declaratives and interrogatives. Let's get started.
This is our topic of the day, reporting statements, commands and requests and questions. Whenever we need to report somebody's words, exact words spoken by them, we opt for reported speech. What sort of changes we make when we transform the sentence from direct speech to indirect speech or reported speech? Let us see. Reported speech is also called as indirect speech. Let us start with pronoun changes. Look at these words. These are the pronouns that they change form in reported speech. I is changed to he or she. Depends on the sentence. Look at the example. He said, I am your teacher. He said that he was our teacher. So here I is changed to he. And one more pronoun that changes form is we. These two first person pronouns and you second person pronoun. We changes to they. They said, we are your new neighbors. So here we is changed to, they said that they were our new neighbors. We change to they. And second person pronoun you. It may either change to I or we depending upon the context. She said, do you have a marker? She asked me whether I had a marker. So this you has been transformed into I in reported speech. Let us look at time and place words and demonstratives. Demonstratives are nothing but this, that and these, those. Word changes, let us see, time and place words. Now becomes then, today becomes that day, yesterday becomes the previous day, tomorrow becomes the next day, tonight becomes that night, last night becomes the previous night, next week becomes the following week, and ago becomes before. Okay? This becomes that, these becomes those. Okay? And place word here becomes there. Okay, so these are the basic changes that happen in reported speech. Whenever we transform any direct speech sentence or a passage into reported speech, these are the changes that we need to keep in mind. One thing is pronoun changes, other thing is time and place words and demonstratives. And one more important rule that we are going to talk now, let us see what it is. Most important and most confusing rule of this reported speech is backshift rule of tenses. Now look at the tense and how does it change to in reported speech. Simple present tense, it becomes simple past tense. Present continuous becomes past continuous. Present perfect becomes past perfect. Present perfect continuous becomes past perfect continuous. So till this present tense we don't have any problem because we can see the shift of this tense very clearly. Present tense, past tense. Present continuous, past continuous. Present perfect, past perfect. Present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous. And then simple past tense. What happens to it in reported speech? It changes to past perfect tense. Here, many of the students lose mark here. Simple past tense to past perfect. I have seen so many students, however bright they are, however they are good with their grammar concept. But this particular thing, why I don't know, they don't understand and they lose mark very easily. Now, I don't want the same thing to happen with you. That's why I'm pretty clearly telling you, simple past tense becomes past perfect tense. Past continuous becomes past perfect continuous. Okay? And then past perfect tense doesn't change. Even past perfect continuous tense also doesn't change in reported speech. And simple future tense will changes to would. Future continuous will be changes to would be along with V1 plus ing. Future perfect will have changes to would have. Future perfect continuous will have been changes to would have been. So basically will becomes would. That thing you need to remember as far as future tense is concerned. And then look at the examples. She said, I work in a bank. Present simple. It changes to past simple. She said that she worked in a bank. And then she said, I am working in a bank. This is present continuous. It becomes, she said that she was working in a bank. She said, I have worked in a bank. She said that she had worked in a bank. Have worked has become had worked. And here she said, I have been working in a bank. And she said that she had been working. Have been has become had been. I worked in a bank. It is simple past tense. It becomes past perfect. She had worked in a bank. And was working. I was working in a bank. Past continuous. It becomes past perfect continuous. That is, she had been working in a bank. Okay. And then, I had worked. Past perfect. It remains the same. Had worked remain. Had worked only. Okay. So the teacher said, I had been watching you. This is past perfect continuous, which doesn't change its form in reported speech as well. She had been watching me. No change at all. And then he said, I will meet you on Monday. He said that he would meet me. Will meet becomes would meet. And then I will be writing future continuous. It has become she would be writing. Okay. And then I will have finished 5 years in this office by 2021. So here this is future perfect tense. And it has become would have finished. He said that he would have finished 5 years in that office by 2021. So will have finished became would have finished. I will have been living in Paris for 15 years by this August. That is future perfect continuous. And then she said that she would have been living in Paris for 15 years by that August. So, will have been living has become would have been living. Only changes with this will becomes would in future tense forms. Okay. And now let us look at declarative sentences. As we have discussed already, this is our topic. Reporting, statements, commands and requests. And questions. Okay. So let us start with declarative sentences. Those are nothing but statements. He said, I need to travel a lot in my job. See, as far as declarative sentences are concerned, the changes that we discussed already are more than enough. We are not going to make any other changes in declarative sentences. We apply all those rules, like backshift rule, we apply pronominal changes, we apply another word, time, place, and demonstratives. Changes we apply. That's it. Okay. And one more important thing is that acts as a conjunction when we transform declarative sentences into reported speech. But it is not the same with imperatives and interrogatives. Let us see what is that difference. Okay. He said, I need to travel a lot in my job. He said that he needed to travel a lot in his job. So need has become needed. Simple present tense became simple past tense. Nayan said, I have finished my homework. So have finished is present perfect. Nayan said that is the conjunction. As I have told you in declarative sentences, that acts as conjunction. Nayan said that he had finished his homework. So, have finished, present perfect has been changed to past perfect, had finished. Okay, and this pronominal changes, you can see, I had become he. Mom said, I will come to Delhi in July. Will come. This is simple future. Okay, what happens to it? Let us see. Mom said that she would come to Delhi in July. So, backshift rule, we are not leaving anywhere. We have to apply backshift rule. So, will past tense form would. Okay. And then he said, she has been sleeping since this morning. Has been sleeping. This is present perfect continuous tense. What happens to it? She said that she had been sleeping since that morning. So present perfect continuous has become past perfect continuous. So back shift we are not going to leave at all. She said to me, I had scored 90% in my math. So had scored, had plus V3 is past perfect. What happens to it, my dears? Yeah, it doesn't change its form. Let us see. She told me that she had scored 90% in her math. So had scored has remained had scored only. There is no change in past perfect tense and past perfect continuous tense. And rest of the tense forms will be changing. You have to keep that in mind. And backshift rule, you are not supposed to leave it. Then come imperative sentences. They are also called as commands and requests. Commands, requests, suggestions, orders. Okay. All those are imperative sentences. And the subject of imperative sentence is always you. It is not mentioned. In the place of said to, we use ordered, commanded, suggested, requested, told, proposed, asked. All these are called as reporting verbs. Reporting verbs said to will be replaced by any of these reporting verbs. And then we use an infinitive 2 plus V1 as reported verb. Okay. So in the part that we change into reported speech, we use 2 plus V1. This acts as conjunction instead of that in imperative sentences. We don't use that in imperative sentences. We use 2 plus V1. That is an infinitive. We don't apply backshift rule here. Irrespective of the tenses, we follow 2 plus V1 structure. That's it. 2 plus V1s, I mean infinitives, do not follow any tense or time. We already know that. Pronominal, time and place words, demonstrative, these words change accordingly. There is no change. The teacher said to us, keep quiet. Who is the subject here? You. Always. Imperative sentence subject is not mentioned, but it is always you. Teacher said to us, you keep quiet. Okay. Then the teacher told us, said to has become told. The teacher told us to keep quiet. What we have done, simply we have added 2 plus V1. That's it. Okay. There is no change otherwise. The god said to the tourists, don't touch the artifacts. And it changes to the god asked the tourists not to touch the artifacts. If you look at this don't, okay, it has become not to. Okay. We are not supposed to write to not. It is not 2 plus V1. 2 plus V1 is always together. Okay. So this negation has come forward, not to touch the artifacts. The officer said to the employees, mind your work. The officer commanded the employees to mind their work. So pronominal changes you might be observing, I believe. Your has become their. Okay. And this 2 plus V1, to mind. Sia said to me, please give me a glass of water. What is the tone of this? Please request. Okay. So we will use that requested as reporting verb. Sia requested me to give her a glass of water. What was her request? Please give me a glass of water. Okay. When we transform this imperative into reported speech, we add an infinitive 2 plus V1 give. Okay. To give her a glass of water. And let us look at one special imperative structure, that is let structure, let sentences. She said to us, let's watch movies this weekend. How does it sound to you? It sounds like a suggestion, right? So she proposed that we should watch movies that weekend. Let's is nowhere seen in the transformation, if you have observed. Tone is proposal. She proposed that we should watch movies that weekend. See here, this is also imperative, but I haven't used 2 plus V1 structure here. Instead of that, what have I done? I have used a that clause. Okay. She proposed something. This that clause is a noun clause. Okay. She proposed that we should watch movies that weekend. Let's watch in the sense they should watch. That is her suggestion or proposal. He said to his friends, let's go to the canteen. That is also a proposal or a suggestion. Okay. He suggested to his friends that they should go to the canteen. He suggested to his friends that they should go to the canteen. Okay, let sentences always use this should structure. Okay, should plus v1. Then mom said to us, let's eat our lunch. Mom suggested that we should eat our lunch. Okay, so like this, let imperatives are changed to reported speech by using should plus v1 structure instead of 2 plus v1. Okay, instead of 2 plus v1, we have used a that clause over here. These are exceptions, that's why I have included here. And then interrogative sentences, they are also called as questions. Two types of interrogatives are WH questions, which start with what, where, when, who, or how. Yes or no questions, which start with helping verbs. What are helping verbs? Be forms, have forms, do forms, and modals. Okay, these are helping verbs. In the case of WH questions, the conjunction that is replaced by the same WH word. Whenever we transform interrogative sentences into reported speech, we don't see that as a conjunction. In case of WH questions, that is replaced by the same WH word that is used in the sentence. Okay. And in the case of yes or no questions, the conjunction that is replaced by whether or if. Children make a mistake in the spelling of this one, whether. Okay, if you are not so comfortable with this word, use only if. Okay, so reporting verbs, usual reporting verbs in interrogative sentences are asked, questioned, inquired, or enquired. Okay, rest of the changes are as usual. The pronominal changes, time and place words, and demonstratives, those changes are as usual. There is no change in that. She said to me, where do you live? She asked me where I lived. Where is this do form in the reported speech? What happened to it? This live has become lived. So, do plus live is live. Did plus live is lived. Okay, so we have changed it like that because all reported speech sentences should end in a period, a full stop. Okay, they don't take any other punctuation mark other than a full stop. So in order to put a full stop in all the sentences to make them as declarative sentences, we need to do structural changes as well. Interrogative sentences, you know, are a bit tricky in that sense because for every interrogative sentence, whenever we change it to reported speech, we need to do those structural changes. Okay, so here what happened? Where is the question verb followed by a verb here? Okay, a helping verb, and then comes the subject. Okay, but in the reported speech, what have I done? Where, question word, and then comes the subject. Okay, WH word, subject, and then verb. Okay, in direct speech, what happened? WH word, verb, and then subject. Okay, these structural changes are a must. We have to do that whenever we transform interrogatives into reported speech. The police officer said to him, where are you coming from? So here, what is the question? Where are you coming from? WH word is used over here followed by a verb. What happens to it in reported speech? The police officer inquired where he was coming from. So where are, verb. Okay, but here subject. Okay, so WH word followed by subject, then only we can afford a full stop at the end of the sentence. Okay, and then the girl said to the shopkeeper, do you sell marker pens? So what sort of question it is? Yeah, it is a yes or no question. Okay, so in yes or no questions, what acts as the conjunction? Let us see. The girl asked or inquired the shopkeeper whether he sold marker pens. And then he said to the stranger, can I borrow your book? He asked the stranger whether he could borrow his book. Okay. In WH question, WH word is followed by a verb, whereas in yes or no questions, yes or no word, that is helping verb, is followed by a subject over here. Okay. That is the striking difference between these two types of questions. And then here is your simple quiz. Transform the following sentences into reported speech. The teacher said to Vian, "Can you solve this puzzle?" Harry said to his boss, "May I take leave tomorrow?" Mom said to me, "Give me your school diary." He said to her, "I appreciate your frankness." Rina said to Nita, "Am I looking good in this dress?" The shopkeeper said to me, "Take these mangoes." The officer said to him, "Who were you talking to 5 minutes ago?" So these are the simple sentences. You can try changing them into reported speech. Before changing them into reported speech, try to identify what type of sentences they are, whether statements or imperatives or commands or requests or questions. Okay? Wish you all the best.
So friends, that is about reporting imperatives, declaratives and interrogatives. Whenever you attempt to write anything, narrate any incident or any story or your day-to-day incidents, you will definitely need this reported speech. So better you learn it now and practice it on daily basis. Meet you soon with another interesting video. Bye for now guys. Thank you so much for being with me.